Okay, in this video, I want to talk to you about writing a cover letter. Okay, there's a plethora of information out there about writing a resume. There's far less information available about a cover letter. Okay, so in this video, I just want to describe to you a general approach that will guide you through the process, okay, for regardless of the type of company you're applying for or the situation. Okay, so to start with, ask yourself, what do you want to communicate? Well, to start with, the cover letter is a sales message. All right, you're selling yourself in a way to the employer. You're convincing them of your value proposition, but you're also trying to achieve other things, right? So what exactly are you trying to sell? You're trying to demonstrate competence, of course, so your resume will reflect your history and things like that. But your cover letter is an opportunity to explain, once again, how your prior experience and things like that relate to the job. So you can use it with the purpose of saying what you've done in the past and how that relates to value for the company. Okay, so that being said, the cover letter is simply a complement to. It is a furtherance of the resume. All right. So as a sales message, the first thing you're going to do is try to get the person's attention. Now you're going to say, yes, I'm applying for this position, right? But the first line has opportunity to, in other ways, grab the person's position. How can you say that in a way that's captivating, right? The way that I like to recommend to others is if you can really do your footwork, you can really plan and prepare. If you are able to network with someone from the company and talk to them about the position, okay, get information, get any additional facts, things like that you need or would be useful to you, or if nothing else, just to simply discuss the position, the company, that type of thing. Then when you're applying, when you say, I'm super excited to be applying for this position after speaking with John Smith, blah, blah, blah. One, that creates some sort of an obligation on the person who reads it to follow up and see who John Smith is. And if it is someone that's known in the company, now there's some sort of social contract that that person is probably going to thoroughly read your resume. They even may call over to the person you reference just with the purpose of seeing if they recommend you or what their take on you is, that type of thing. So once again, it can help get your resume read. That's a great attention getter. Other ways may just simply be an artful way of saying how excited you are or how you learned about the position, that type of thing. Okay, so there you go. You're saying, I'm applying for the position. And from there, for the next two or three lines, you should demonstrate that you understand something about the company. That is, you should demonstrate that you have a working knowledge of the company and explain to them why that fits well with you. Okay, so what you're doing here is saying what you want a job, and here's why I want it, right? You're showing you understand aspects of the company. Where can you find this stuff? The company's values, how it works. Well, their website, right? So go to the website, look at the mission, look at the strategic plan or objectives, that type of thing, and mention those types of things that you understand and know about the company. All right. After that first, no more than five, but 3 to 5 lines, right, in that first paragraph where you introduce yourself and say why you want the position. Next, you can move into explaining why you've done what you've done in your past. Meaning, your resume is a snapshot in history. It's frozen in time. It's backward looking, right? The cover letter is present and forward looking. Okay, it says that, look, as you can see on my resume, I have a wealth of experience in blah, blah, blah. Now, one important thing there, do not repeat what's in your resume. That's a waste of time. It doesn't help anybody. Explain things, make reference to it, right? As you can see, right, in my resume, the person will then look back at your resume, that type of thing. But you don't need to say, I had a job working for so-and-so, so-and-so, I had a job. That's all in your resume. They can see that. But you can say, given my industry experience in this area, this area, and this area, and then work to demonstrate how that translates value to the company. So start with saying, this is why I've done these things in my past. This is the path I'm on. This is what I've always been interested in, that type of thing. So the why about you. Your resume can't do that. Your cover letter can. Tells the why about you. And then slowly transition that into how all of this about me relates value to you or provides value to you. Okay, just like in a sales message, you're making it a you message, a message for the other person. You're selling them on your value and how you add value. Okay, so again, 3 to 5 lines in the very first paragraph saying you want the position and here's why. Then in the second paragraph, 5 to 7, but no more than 8 or 9 lines where you explain, this is the why about my past. These are the things that I've done, and this is how it translates into value for you. Now, as an option, you can put a third paragraph. I call this the aspirational paragraph. Tell them what you aspire to. Now, the important thing here is that it must exist in the company. Don't dare say you aspire to something that doesn't exist in the company. No one wants to hire somebody who will leave later, right, or will not be fully engaged in the job. So pick something along the career path that exists in the company. You're applying to be a marketing analyst. Your dream is to one day be a vice president of marketing in charge of this type of sector, right, that type of thing. It shows, one, you understand the company, but two, gives them assurance that, yes, there is a career path. As long as everybody's needs are met, you will, should move along that career path to some extent if they make, you know, the right choice for the right candidate, that type of thing. So anyway, you're demonstrating, again, you know the company, and potentially you're a good fit, right? You're not going to be leaving. All right, so one thing I do like to include in there is the only people who are ever hired to change things are executives, okay? Everyone else adds value, okay? Adds value to something that already exists. With that being said, don't say that you're going to change something. If you want to demonstrate your value proposition, say, I look forward to learning and growing with a team of consummate professionals, right? Something like that. Learning and growing, that contributes, right? It shows that you have improvement to do, but you're bringing your skills to the table, that type of thing, right? If you can, again, demonstrate some level of fit, translating what you've done in the past into words that make sense as to, this is how I fit with the company, this is how I bring value, this is how I fit in with the culture, that type of thing. And then simply close out the cover letter the way you do with any formal letter, you know, sincerely, truly, truly yours, respectfully, that type of thing, comma, below it, your name, a signature block, signed. You probably want to do a CC at the bottom left that says, you know, resume, whatever else you're including down there, including, I don't know, references, a portfolio, whatever they've asked for you to include. But if you include all of those things in there, make sure they're lined out. But okay, so just to summarize one last time, attention getter and why you want the job, first paragraph. Second paragraph, the why about you and how that creates value for the company. No more than 8 or 9 lines. Third paragraph, 3 to 5 lines that simply says, this is what I aspire to, but really I look to join a team of professionals and learn and grow here in this organization. Okay, sincerely, there you go. It doesn't repeat, it adds to or amplifies your resume, and hopefully will do its job in selling you as a viable candidate for the position.